my name is Priscilla, and today I'm going to be talking to you about sun protection and sunscreen. Even though we do need the sun for its vitamin D, it helps our bones and helps our growth. Too much exposure could lead to some serious consequences, including sunburns, sun cancers, or heat strokes. Some ways you can protect yourself from the sun is by protective clothing, including hats, shirts, and sunglasses. It's very important to protect your eyes, especially from the sun. The best way to protect yourself from the sun would be sunscreen. You can use anything that has an SPF over 15. SPF is just how much it can reflect the sun away from your skin. There's different options that you can use for your sunscreens. There's this brand. You can use it either when you're at the pool, at the wet, the beach. It says that it's sweat and waterproof, which is really good if you're gonna be out and about. For more casual sunscreens, you can use any type of just face guard. This one prevents from aging, and this one's just moisturizer and for sunscreen. There's also sunscreen chemicals put in different type of lip balms to also protect all of your exposed skin from the sun. You should place at least one of these on before you leave the house. Even on cloudy days, there's still sun outside that can hurt you. Sunburns can be very fatal or not so fatal. Not so fatal is just red and itchy and ends up healing. So fatal is when it blisters, it pops, it affects you internally. You feel kind of woozy, you have chills. If that happens, you do have to call your doctor and let them know what's going on. Other than that, that is the basics on sunscreen and sun protection. Just make sure you're always protecting yourself when leaving the house and when you know you're going to be in the sun for a very long time. And you can use any of the examples given for your sun protection. Just make sure that you check the expiration date and that it reacts well with your skin. Thank you.